day the dream started, the sunlight streaming through the branches was so bright. And the snow, it felt so cold. I remember a small child was crying, but I can't remember the crying child's face.
Lost track of the time.
My name's not Ayu Ayu.
Okay, then what is your name?
Ayu Tsukimiya.
Wow, that's a pretty normal name. My name's Yuichi Aizawa. Nice to meet you. Well, you want to get going, Ayu Ayu?
Ugu.
Ugu to you too.
Better today.
Of course it is. Nothing tastes good when you eat right after you've been crying your eyeballs out.
Yuichi?
What is it? You're trying to confess your love for me or
it's not
just...
what I was gonna say. Thank you. Hey, Yuichi. Do you love your mom?
Of course I do. Why do you ask?
I love my mom, too.
Why are you telling me this?
I just wanted to say it.
Okay.
You see, my mother went far away. I don't know where she went. Just that she left me behind.
You want to hang out with me again tomorrow?
You mean it?
Yeah. I mean, if you want to.
I remember all the fun times I used to have when my mother was around.
Yeah. up here this time?
It sounded like fireworks.
Where in the world did you buy those things?
Makoto, did you want to play with fireworks?
Well, yeah.
Well, you should have come to me and told me that's what you wanted. If you really want to do something, just come and tell me and I promise I'll hear you out.
Okay.
Right. Now let's all get back to bed. We'll save the fireworks for some other time.
Does that sound good, Makoto?
You know, you should think really long and hard about what you did. Morning, Aunt Akiko.
Well, good morning to you too, Yuichi. You're sure up awfully early for a Sunday morning.
Where's Nayuki?
Oh, she's probably still sleeping. She's got practice later on today, so she'll have to get up sometime soon.
I'd be happy to wake her up if you want me to.
Oh, well, I might just have you do that for me then.
What about Makoto? Is she still asleep too?
I think I might have heard her moving around up there.
Can I have some too, please?
Of course.
Thanks for breakfast.
That really burned my tongue!
Oh, I'm so sorry. I didn't think it might be too hot for you.
Thank you. It was delicious.
Yeah, it was. Thanks so much.
Well, I think I'll go back to my room.
Hugo, why do you have to be such a meanie?
Hey there, Ayu. I didn't see you come in.
I've been sitting here the whole time!
Oh, really? Because I totally didn't realize anyone was here besides Aunt Akiko.
I invited her to have breakfast again today. Meals are so much more enjoyable when shared with friends.
So tell me, Yuichi, what do you think you're gonna do today?
I was just gonna hang here, probably spend the day working on my bonsai.
Oh, come on, Yuichi, you can't just waste a perfectly good Sunday. Why not do something with me?
You mean Dine and Dash?
Oh, shut up!
What are those movie tickets?
Yep, Miss Akiko gave them to me.
Say, you know what movies are playing right now?
Sure don't, but I think those passes are only good to the end of the day.
Then would you like to go see something with me?
That does sound like a lot of fun.
Oh,
just kidding. Both Nayuki and I are going to be pretty busy, so why don't the two of you go?
A movie, huh? That doesn't sound too shabby.
It's set! We'll see it together! I'll see you at 5 o'clock in front of the station.
Sounds good to me. See you then.
Mm-hmm. Good. Thanks for breakfast, Miss Akiko.
A movie with Ayu, huh?
Well, well. Sounds like a date.
Come on, don't be ridiculous. That's crazy.
A date?
Why don't you go back to sleep?
Why would I do that? I just woke up.
I'm impressed you got up by yourself.
I heard some sort of crash by the front door. Like maybe somebody fell down, because afterwards I heard a voice say, that hurt my head bone.
I swear that is one clumsy kiddo.
I wonder if she was just so happy that she lost her footing.
She's always been totally accident-prone.
That makes it sound like you've known Ayu for a long time.
She's a friend from before. I met her when I used to visit this town as a kid.
Oh. Wouldn't it be incredible if she's just been waiting all this time for him to finally return?
What?
Oh, don't mind me. I was just thinking aloud.
Sleep or eat, just choose one or the other. After that stunt you pulled last night, I'm surprised you have the gall to be acting so chipper.
I'm allowed to look however I want, thank you very much.
Hold on just a second. You and I need to talk.
Huh? What are these things for?
I bought them thinking I'd look for a part-time job, but before I do that, I figured we'd look for something to keep you busy.
A job? You mean you want me to work?
I think the reason you don't have any common sense is because you lack real-world experience. Once you learn that your actions have consequences, you'll learn the difference between right and wrong. And as a bonus, once you get paid, you can buy as many pork buns and comic books as you want. So what do you want to do for a living?
Maybe a job reading comics all day? Oh!
Do not be a retard when I'm trying to help you out.
I'm not! Well, look at that! I think that'll be just perfect! Yes, the part-time slot. Yes, that's right.
A waitress at a manga cafe?
Uh-huh. I figure if she goes out and meets a bunch of different people, she may start to get her memory back before too long.
Well, yes, I suppose it could be good for her.
They want me to go down there this afternoon for an interview.
That's great, Makoto. You just might have yourself a job by dinner time.
I'm not so sure about that.
You gotta believe in yourself. Come on, I'll walk with you part of the way.
Oh.
Right. Well, good luck in there, Makoto.
You aren't coming in with me?
There's no point in my going in there now. Once you get the job, I'll come back as a customer, okay? And watch your manners in there. Make sure to speak respectfully.
I know that, jerk face!
Now Yuki's got practice today. I wonder if Nayuki's out running or something. She wouldn't be out here on a Sunday, would she?
Hello there.
What are you doing out here again?
I could ask you the same thing, Yuichi.
Well, my friend Nayuki has track practice today, and I was coming out here to see her.
But the track team doesn't ever practice way over here.
Okay, you caught me. I was actually gonna dig a pit to catch a certain someone. Someone who keeps coming here even though she's sick.
I don't like people who say things like that.
Shiori?
Yes?
I really hope you haven't been wandering around out here since noon.
Okay, you guessed right.
You know, this is why you're never gonna get well enough to come back to school. I mean, what in the world are you thinking?
It really is strange, huh? I know no one's here, but I still come back. And sure enough, when I get here, there's no one. Yet I can't leave. I cling to the faint hope that just maybe this person will come. But every day it's the same. I end up all alone. And for some reason, I wait, and I wait, until it gets dark. I'm a fool, huh?
Can't argue with that.
Thank you, Yuichi.
That's some sunset, isn't it?
Yeah.
If I ask you a question, will you give me an honest answer?
As long as it's not about my weight or body measurements.
Tell me, why do you come to this place every day? Who is it you're looking for?
I honestly couldn't tell you why. I come to find answers because I don't know where else to look. Does that answer your question? That was a pretty good answer, don't you think so?
Not really.
Ah, that was kind of mean. I thought it was rather poetic.
God, the bells! That means it's gotta be...
Yeah, they ring every day at 5 o'clock.
Oh, crap! Oh man, sorry I'm late. I had some stuff to do and just lost track of time.
It's okay, I'm just glad you finally came.
You know, I thought you'd dress up a little, but it looks like you're wearing the same thing you wore this morning.
Of course I am, this is my favorite coat.
Are you laughing because you're happy to see a movie?
Yeah, I guess I'm excited to see the movie too, but what really makes me happy is that the person I was waiting for showed up. That alone makes me feel like all the waiting was totally worth it.
Aren't you being a little dramatic?
Oh no, not at all.
Waiting, yeah.
Oh good, looks like we're gonna make it in time.
Do we have any idea which movies are playing?
No, I hardly ever go to the movie theater. But I remembered that my mom and dad used to take me a lot when I was a little kid.
So, why did they stop taking you?
I can't remember.
The Eye of Terror is supposed to be the scariest movie out there. I heard that so many people have passed out while they were watching it that some theaters won't even show it anymore. Come on, we don't want to miss the beginning. Don't tell me you're actually scared of this.
Not at all!
Cool, that dude's body just blew up.
That's great!
You're pretty calm for somebody who doesn't usually watch this kind of stuff.
I love it!
You're never gonna see the show if you keep that coat over your head.
Why'd you do that?
Aren't you even gonna watch a little bit?
I am!
You've got your eyes squeezed shut and your coat on your head.
This is just how I watch movies.
We came all the way here, you might as well watch the thing. Besides, you look a little ridiculous wearing a coat anyway.
Pooh-goo, why are you so mean?
It's actually impressive that you can say oogoo in so many ways. Seriously, get a hold of yourself.
I'm so exhausted.
You never even looked at the screen one time, did you?
I feel a little better now.
Man, you are such a drama queen.
I've been terrified of stories about ghosts and evil spirits ever since I was little.
Still, don't you think you overdid it a bit? Besides, in a situation like that, doesn't the girl usually do something like, and then maybe bury her head in the guy's shoulder?
I couldn't even think that far.
You see, that's why people sometimes think you're a 12-year-old boy.
You're the only one who would say something like that. Everyone knows I'm a girl.
Only because you're wearing that headband.
Even if I wasn't, they'd still know.
Really? Because I think that if you took off that headband, cut your hair real short, and sat next to a 12-year-old boy, nobody'd be able to tell the difference.
But I'm a girl and I'm in high school. I may not be the tallest girl in class, but I'm still the same age as you. It's already pitch black out here.
Guess we should probably call it a day. I had a really nice time. Thank you for coming.
Yeah, I had a good time too.
See ya.
Have a good night, Yuichi.
See ya.
Yeah, have a good night now.
Why are you following me?
Because the dark street is scary.
This is far enough, isn't it?
Feel
free to answer either yes or okay.
Those mean the same thing.
If you keep following me around, you're never going to be able to get back home. Or is this your way of asking me to walk you?
I'm okay. I'll just go.
Are you sure about that?
Yeah.
Okay, then I'll see you later, Ayu.
Right. Have a good night, Yuichi. Yuichi, you're a meanie, Popohead! Meanie!
I think that's about enough of that. Come to think of it, I don't have any idea where she lives. You did what?
I sort of fell asleep in the interview. It got kind of boring, so I nodded off. And then they told me that I should just go on home.
I understand. Nothing makes me sleepier than having to sit and listen to somebody.
Please don't encourage her.
If you want Makoto, I can talk to a friend of mine and see if maybe she can give you a job.
Huh?
She runs a small nursery school and she was just telling me the other day that they're really short-handed. Right. Then she'll be there tomorrow. Thanks so much. She said she looks forward to having you.
That's so great. Congrats.
Aww, at a daycare?
I'm sure you can handle playing with a bunch of little kids all day. After all, you're kind of like a little kid yourself.
But I don't know if I'd be any good at that.
Of course you will be. I wouldn't have suggested it otherwise. Just go in there and do your best, Makoto.
It's about that time. What the heck am I doing coming back here? Mai! You hurt yourself?
Don't think so.
Was it a demon?
Mm-hmm. It's gone now.
Are you sure?
Yuichi?
Huh?
You shouldn't come back here after dark for a while. You should stay close to that girl.
What girl? Oh, you mean Makoto? You said something about how I should be nice to her last night. What were you talking about? Do you know something about Makoto that I don't?
I don't know anything for sure. It's just that...
Just what?
She'll be needing you soon, more than anyone else ever has. Do your best to help her. It's just a feeling I have.
What kind of feeling?
Mm-hmm.
I'm home!
I didn't know that you'd got out again.
Yeah, I was hunting demons.
So when you say hunting for demons, what does that mean?
I really don't know. How about this? I went out to find answers because I don't know where else to look.
Yeah, I'm more confused now than I was a second ago.
I'll tell you what, this crazy world is chock full of confusing stuff. How come you're always in there when I want a bath?
Well, I'm all done, so go ahead and take your bath.
What is that smell? It's miso soup! Makoto!
Oh, that hurt!
What the heck were you thinking, making a bathtub full of miso soup?
Oh, yeah? What makes you so sure it was me?
Because no one else would be that stupid, that's why!
Well, I didn't do it, and you don't have any proof!
This was another one of your dumb pranks,
well,
just admit
it! I didn't do anything! Now why don't you go put some clothes on and leave me alone?
What, she got a problem with my towel?
Can you tell me something?
If you do, I'm gonna report you to the police, you pervert!
Huh? It's not right to waste food like this, understand?
Yes, ma'am. I understand.
You pull the same kind of stupid tricks over and over again. When the heck are you gonna learn your lesson?
I don't know.
We'll just have to drain it. And then we'll wash the bathtub, okay?
She'll be needing you soon, more than anyone else ever has. Do your best to help her.
Oh, just about Mai's constipation.
Oh?
It really seems to like you. I think I'll go out for a bit.
I think we have a lot in common. We're both strays with nowhere to go.